Let's see this question asked in the CBSE examination 2002 year. This question is, find the area of the region xy such that x squared less than equal to y less than equal to mod x. So this question is different because it has modulus involved. Now we already know how to do a question based on application of integrals in this chapter. So we are going to follow a diagrammatic approach. First we'll be drawing the rough sketch or the main sketch, and then we'll move about solving the question based on that sketch and the points of intersection. So as you can see here, this part is fine. We are not concerned much with x square less than equal to y, but what will trouble us would be this y less than equal to mod x. Don't worry, first see, x square less than equal to y means again a case like x square equal to y. So x square equal to y should be an upward facing parabola. So it should be upward facing parabola. And after we have made this very clear in our mind that what kind of a parabola is this, next would be the involvement of modulus. Now this modulus can break in a manner like it can break as x and it can break as minus x. So when y is equal to x would be when x is greater than equal to 0, this would be when x is less than 0. What about y is equal to x? How do we draw this y is equal to x? At an angle of theta is equal to 45 degree, the slope will be 1 and it will be drawn this side. So it is somewhere here and you can see this is somewhere here. This is the point of intersection, but exactly what point is it? We'll be putting in the equation and knowing. So it should be made at an angle of 45 degree. Similarly, what about y is equal to minus x? Again, you would be seeing that this is in the negative direction and its point of intersection is also well defined. So there would be two points of intersection here, and this is your point 0, 0, which is the origin. Let me name it as O. And what is the first point of intersection for this line, which is y is equal to x, and for this line, which is y is equal to minus x, and here is the curve, x square is equal to y. What all things are running in our mind? We are concerned with finding what? The points of intersection. So if x is equal to y, if I put it here, let me name these as equations by writing solution. I have first as x square is equal to y, this is equation number 1. I have x is equal to y, which is equation number 2. I have y is equal to minus x, which is equation number 3. Nothing more than this. Let me put 2 in 1. So x is equal to y means x is equal to x square, because y is substituted by x, or x square minus x is equal to 0, or x into x minus 1 is equal to 0. X is equal to 0 and 1. So this is 1. When I put the same thing in 1, so x is equal to 0 means x square is equal to y, which is equal to 0. So y is equal to 0. So we have one point as 0, 0, which is the origin, is the intersection. What about the other thing? I have 1. So 1 square is equal to y, that means 1. So 1, 1. When my x is equal to 1, 1, 1 would be the point of intersection. So this is 1, 1. So that means here it is 1, 0. And see, this is O, C, point I have named. And this may be a point, say A. Understood? Now similarly, following the similar strategy for putting 3 in 1, you can find out this point of intersection. That is a task for you. That will come out to be minus 1, 1. That means I can name this point as A and this point as D. And this should be 1, which can be named as point E, which is 0, 1. Now as you can see, what we are concerned is, let's read the question, find the area of the region this. So that means you are about to find this shaded area as well as this shaded area, and that will complete your answer. Now as you know, we are more pretty comfortable integrating with respect to x. I know that here it is minus 1, 0. So minus 1 to 0 first we are going, then we are going from 0 to 1. That is what I will be writing. I am going from minus 1 to 0, then I am going from 0 to 1. The first thing. The second thing, minus 1 to 0, upper curve is this line, lower is this parabolic curve. So lines equation, so it is minus x dx minus, so let me write dx together, I'll be writing dx together better. So first curve minus the second curve, minus is the equation of the parabola, parabola's equation x square, now dx, plus from 0 to 1 now you are traveling, upper is what, upper is this which is x, minus, minus is the parabola, so it is what, you have to see what is the equation of y, again it is x square dx. Beware of the limits, you are going from minus 1 to 0, then 0 to 1. What is the answer? Minus x square by 2 minus x cube by 3 from minus 1 to 0 plus x square by 2 minus x cube by 3 0 to 1. Let's do it together. This should be upper limit you have to put. Upper limit does not give me anything because it is 0. Then have a minus sign, put minus 1. So it is minus 1 by 2 because minus 1 whole square is 1. Then minus, put minus 1 plus 1 by 3. Plus this side. This side you see 1 is there. So it is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3. Lower limit does not give me any answer. So see minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. Minus minus is there which becomes plus. 1 by 2, 1 by 2 is 1. Then minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3 is 2 by 3 in minus. So the answer should be 1 by 3 square units. And that is how you solve this. So first we found out the points of intersection and then we move for the further part of the solution here in the form of integral. So this is my I and this is also my I integral, and that is the answer, 1 by 3 square units.